Welcome to the lesson on visualizing in three dimensions. In this lesson, we will take a look at some basic shapes like cubes in basic views to see how we can create two-dimensional views of those figures. Now let's imagine we have a 4x4 gridded cube, and then we paint this cube. It's important to note that because it's 4x4, it's essentially made up of smaller cubes, and that as we paint it, some of the cubes would get painted on three faces, and some of these cubes would get painted only on two faces. And then, of course, some of the cubes, the ones in the middle, would only get painted on one face. Now, we wonder why, and it doesn't take us long to figure out. It simply is because those are the faces that are exposed as the cube is put together. Some of those cubes, the ones on the corners, are three. Some of them, the ones on the ends, are two faces. And then, of course, the ones in the middle have one face. So we might think, how many of each cube is available in there? If we turn it, how many faces are there? We know a cube has six faces, but generally speaking, how can we turn this into an orthographic projection and visualization? So an orthographic projection is the view of an object that is perpendicular to a plane or face of an object. Now, when I draw these five cubes in this orthographic grid, it looks as if it's three-dimensional. And because the different faces that are facing a different way are all different colors, we interpret this as three-dimensional. But I could look at this three-dimensional figure from the top, from the left, and from the front or the back, and then get the six views that I have here on the right-hand side. So even though I have five cubes available, from the top, I would only see four. From the bottom, I would see four. From the back and from the front, I would see four. And then from the right, I would only see available three cubes. The same thing from the left. Even though there are five cubes available, some of the cubes would literally block the other's points of view. Now let's take a look at drawing an orthographic cube. So I'll draw the first by connecting six of these dots in such a way that you would understand visually seeing three faces of my cube. Now in drawing the next cube, I don't connect all the dots so that you see that some of the faces are blocked out by the already established cubes. Now to draw a few more stacked on top of each other, I continue to draw some of the lines, purposely not connecting some of these dots so that you understand that some of the faces of my cubes are not made visible because they are behind other cubes. So as I continue to draw this, you understand that I have a total of seven cubes here. And generally speaking, what we might understand as a T-shape. So how would I take this and transfer it to two-dimensional dot paper? How do I draw the six orthographic views of this orthographic figure that I drew? Well, from one side, I would have three cubes in a line with two cubes above and two cubes, I should say squares rather, above one of the end squares. This would be the view from the left or the right. Either way you look at it, left or right, it just would be facing the other ways. And we'll take a closer look at that later. From the front, we would only see five squares in a row, because either the middle squares would be facing towards us or in the back. Now the top view, I would only get the two cubes jutting out and then the ones in the top, so I would only see three squares. And the same thing would end up happening from the bottom view. Let's do another example so that we can get some practice. So we have another figure, and I want to think, well, how many cubes are represented here? So we first start off by thinking I can count six cubes, and I know the different faces. So let's go ahead and draw what is the view from the left going to look like. Well, since I have three cubes stacked up, I would really only see three squares from either the left or the right side. Then also imagine what would the view look like from the top or from the bottom. And the same thing, how many yellow faces in that image are available? Well, I would only see three in a row from either the top or the bottom, three squares. Again, regardless of knowing I have six cubes here. Now, where we get some change is if I look at it from the front. Because from the front side, I know that the left side of my front is only two cubes tall and the right side is only three cubes tall. And if I were to do it from the back side, this would be flipped. The left side would be 3 cubes tall, and the right would be 2 cubes tall. Now, it's this visualization that makes it very important when it comes to thinking of more complex 3-dimensional geometry.